other persons. Here it is. Here.
So thank you very much for your interesting lecture. You mentioned the travelogue of Marco Polo in Milione and the way he describes Tibet. So I have a question. What kind of stereotypes or ways of looking at Tibetan Buddhism in the West have you found in your own experience? Are there some kind of common misunderstandings or stereotypes of Tibetan Buddhism in the West that need to be corrected?
我刚才在我的演讲当中也讲了，有些极少数人呢确实有，包括藏传佛教的有些佛藏品呢就不真实啊，然后西藏人呢他是一个非常野蛮的一种民族啊，因为当时还有一本书，其实在这里面对西藏人的描述呢就是比较负面的，就讲了很多很多的，其实我们现在都是根本找不到这样的历史和这样的传统的有一些，所以可能有些书就是就导致的，就真正去过西藏的话呢就是应该好像他们听到的感觉是不是这样的，但是没有去过的只是看到一些文字上的有个别人的话呢到目前为止还有很多，尤其是有些个别的一些教授的话呢就是他始终研究就是就藏传佛教的有些经论呢就他就通过各种方法来就是想批判，就是也有这样的。
Okay, so I think that in my speech I also mentioned that there are really a small groups of people, maybe they have some misunderstanding of the Tibetan Buddhism, for example, for the review, the treasure, the Dharma, some people believe that this is not real, and also some people think that Tibetan are really not very gentle, they are crazy people, and there is several books about it. But I think if you really have the chance to visit Tibet, you can really feel the conditions there. But if you have not get the chance to go there, only based on some words, and maybe this is not true. And I know several professors, they also try different means to criticize Tibetan Buddhism.
我有两个问题哈，一个就是我觉得藏传佛教是不是离瑞典太远了？是这个太远了，是不是？这个佛教的这个磁场是不是就离我们就更远？是我的想法。还有一个就是，如果我吃肉的话，是不是就信佛和吃肉？我如果不是雷他样，可不可以信这个藏传佛教？
Okay, so basically I have two questions. First of all, is that the case that Tibetan Buddhism is really far away from Sweden? Okay, and the second is that if I want to believe in Buddhism, but I still want to eat meat, I don't want to become vegetarian, is that okay?
这样的，其实藏传佛教离瑞典近的话呢也很近，因为今天我们在这里讲的课呢就是在我们佛学院都是在直播，就是说他们也完全能听得到我们那边的有些课的话呢，我们瑞典这边的很多的佛教徒也在学习，所以所近呢也很近，所远呢也确实比较远，但是如果自己有虔诚的信仰的话呢，远和近应该不成问题，这是第一个问题。
Okay, so about your first question, that you study Tibetan Buddhism, but you mentioned that Tibetan Buddhism may be far, a little bit far away from Sweden. But I think in another aspect, it also close because this lecture was also live streaming in our monastic, and the monks can watch it. And also there are also some online courses that lots of local Swedish also learn it. So you can see maybe from the distance perspective is far away, but in another perspective is also close.
然后第二个问题，你想吃肉的话呢，主要是可能，就皈依后最好不吃肉的观点呢是寒川佛教为主，藏传佛教呢也是赞叹这个吃素，赞叹吃素，但是并不是学了藏传佛教都不让吃肉，就是也没有这样的，根据自己的情况，我看你们的瑞典呢，就是其实。很多人吃素，就是这一天我是出乎我的意料。就我以前在很多资料上看过，瑞典人为了健康和为了环保，为了爱护动物，就是就素食主义是非常多的。但这次到了之后的话呢，有一个新的感受，所以我想是你在瑞典应该在素食方面问题不是很大的，偶尔偷偷的吃一点也可以。
Okay, so about your problem about eating meat, and from the Chinese Buddhist tradition, if you take refuge, then you will give up eating meat. But this is not a tradition of Tibetan Buddhism, but of course, Tibetan Buddhism also advocates, okay, we praise the behavior of being vegetarian, but it's not very strict. You can choose it based on your own situations. But I think in this country, Sweden,lots of people are vegetarian. To me, it's also a very surprised. I wrote some material that Swedish people, they, because of the health reasons and because of the protecting the environment and protecting the animals and animal rights, they chose to become vegetarian. You know, I saw some books about this, but this time I really been there. I have some new feelings about this.
Yes, I have a rather specific question about practice because I'm doing research on Confucianism during the Ming Dynasty, and they have a ritual when they are practicing 7 days seclusion, a kind of 7日闭关, and it is meditation during 7 days, and I haveThe impression that there are influences from Buddhism, and it might be also influences from Tibetan Buddhism, because this 7-day meditation is later on in Korea and Japan. So my question is about if there is such a tradition in Tibetan Buddhism at the time. I'm interested in the 16th century.
They are doing research on Tai Zhou Xue
Kuan.
Tai Zhou Xue Kuan. Wang Yangming 的一个。
Wang
Yangming.我对那个王阳明的很多的那个著作啊很感兴趣，他是很有智慧的一个人。
Personally, I'm very interested in some collections of the Wang Yangming.Because I believe that he is a very intelligent person.
其实其他七天的这种闭关或者说七天的念佛只是在佛教当中是提的比较多。
So you mentioned about this 7 days retreat or this 7 days maybe chanting the name of the Buddha. This is mentioned a lot in Buddhism.
比如说佛教的这个阿弥陀经当中呢就念佛的时候若一日若二日若三日若四日一直到若七日就来之不断的念诵对自己的修行如何如何就这样的。
So in the sutra called Amitabha Sutra, In Buddhism, it mentions that you can chant the name of the Amitabha Buddha for 1 day, for 2 days, for 3 days, etc.
其实这个七天呢，不仅仅是一个这个佛教吧，就是它是一种天地运行的一个规律的这个时间的阶段。
I think these 7 days it doesn't only for Buddhism, it also in accordance with astronomy.
包括基督教的话呢，就是我们就是分这个一个礼拜。两个礼拜就是也是这个七天，就是为一个时间的单位。
And in Christianity, we also have for 1 week is 7 days.
像那个藏传佛教的密宗当中的话呢，也是就修行的时候就七天，14天、21天这样的这个七天作为一个节点来这个修行。
And in Tibetan Buddhism, especially in the Vajrayana, Mantrayana, we also have the tradition to practice or to do retreat like for 7 days and 14 days and 21 days. So basically, 7 is one of the stages. Okay.
我们释迦牟尼佛降生的时候也是萨钦德纳贡巴登尔那阿南吉登德纳乔吉松，对整个大地就是迈七步，然后就是说是这个天上天下为我独尊。
And when the Buddha Shakyamuni, when he came into our world, and he also says some following words, and he also walked 7 steps and said that for all the things andfor everything in the world, and I'm the kind of the best, I should be, you know, respected. So he said this.
在天文学当中也是有天上有很多一对七颗星星的。
一对？
对，就是七颗星星作为一对的，就是这样的学说。
So in the astronomy, they also a tradition that for 7 stars, they believe the 7 stars should be one.Kind of collection or one team.
我们实践的一些包括地理和阴阳学当中的话，叫轮王七宝，就是有七个东西的话呢，如果积聚的话，对它加来一种富裕呢，增加一些迹象啊，就这种说法。
So there is also some saying from the geography perspective. We call the Lion King 7.Treasure. So basically, if you can collect or if you have both these 7 things together, you will become very rich.
包括人死的时候呢，就是七七49天当中，他就一直就处于可能会终一生，就是然后呢，就再处于下一世，就接生于下一世。
And also, when the people died, and 7 multiplied 7, this is a 49 days.So Tibetan Buddhism, they believe that after people died in these 49 days, the person remained in the state of bardo.
Some more questions?
你好，在语言书，
在
吗？
里面提到说关于
怎么结合
现在的科技
和。正念的这个概念比较
西方，然后正念，比方说他们讲到怎么样调整你的注意，特别是
关于专注，关于怎么样这个不带评判的觉察，那这个正念的这个概念早从这个佛教当中引入，从大乘佛教和小乘佛教当中，这个概念由比方说像那个西方的卡巴金教授，他把它带到了这个西方的各个领域，比方说像医学领域啊，包括说现在应用到这个经济啊，应用到这个商业的领域，那么可以说是现在当下一个非常流行的把这个佛教的价值和观念引入到这个实际的生活当中去。那么我想听听您的见解，怎么样能够这个运用好科技，运用好科学， 然后这个在这个平时繁忙的生活状态当中调心，找到内心的智慧。
你的问题太广了，科技啊，生活啊，内心啊，我怎么回答呢？
So your question is so broad, technology and the life. So how can I answer it?
不过呢，你讲的很好，在博士论文当中有正念的这样的一个分析，应该说正念。本来正念呢，就是我们佛经当中有一个特别大的经典，就是叫做《正法念处经》。
But on the other hand, I feel that you're very good in your PhD studies. You focus on the mindfulness, and in the in Buddhism, we have a special sutra referred to or speaking about this mindfulness sutra.
佛教里面就是讲的特别重要，尤其是讲得非常深的时候呢，就是叫什么这个数念处、法念处、心念处，就这样的这种四种念处啊，就是完全能观察我们的这个人的无我空性的道理。
So when we dig very deep about this mindfulness, and we have this mindfulness of our body, of our sensations, and of the phenomenon, and in the end, it goes to very deep. It goes to the concept of no self.
身念处，身心法受。
So body, sensation, and dharma or phenomenon, and the mind, and also the mind or the heart.
但你可能研究的应该是现在所谓的专注力。也就是说，我的心就是专注在某个地方。其实这种，不管是在科学领域、生活领域，应该自己心就安静下来。我瑞典不知道有没有修禅修的，其实禅修真的很重要的。如果我们禅修修得很好的话呢，那么生活就有营养，有价值。如果我们禅修修得不好，可能人生都比较痛苦。
But basically, maybe you're for you mostly focus on something related to focus or your concentration. So your mind focusing on something, maybe you refer to this. But if we can really have a peaceful mind, if we relax our mind, so I think this is very important. I don't know whether in Sweden meditation is popular or not, but I personally believe that doing meditation is very important in our lifetime. We will have the real meaning of our life if we can do very good meditation. Otherwise, maybe our life will not be very happy.
很多人认为那个乔布斯啊，他是通过修禅定然后开发就是他心灵的软件，然后呢发现那个苹果的，所以现在为什么苹果，就苹果市卖的那么火，不知道瑞士怎么样，就，所以跟他的这个发现跟他的产地有关系，就这就是很多科学家也这样认为的。
And lots of scientists believe that. The Apple, which was founded by Steve Jobs, lots of the inspirations of the Apple coming from when he did the meditation. And I know that some Apple products nowadays selling very good. I don't know what is the case here in Sweden.
这边苹果社是吧？很多人年轻人喜欢。
This is Apple X. Is a lot of young people are like it or?
我有学过一些佛经，还有学过一些圣经，然后这个里边都说现在的日子是末法时期，还有这个最后的日子。那么我想问一下，上师在藏传佛教里边又是怎么样说的？ 关于说这个最后的日子还有多长的时间。那么因为大家知道现在的人越来越自私，越来越暴力，然后恐怖袭击也到处都是这样不断的发生，所以对于有信仰的有宗教信仰的人来说是一种就是一种长时间的忍耐和觉得非常的无望，并且很期待这个这样的时间赶紧的结束。那么就是我第一个问题就是这个日期还有多长时间大家要去忍受。那么我还有一个问题就是至于说是神厉害还是魔厉害，我不知道就是上师会怎么样去解释和看待这个问题。
所谓的魔法时期呢，其实释迦牟尼佛的佛法当中叫国法时期，还有那个正法时期，就正我的正，还有一个叫教法时期，还有一个叫相法时期。所以现在这个时期呢，前面的国法和正法已经过了，然后在教法时期当中还没有到相法时期，光相法的时候还有500年，所以跟所谓的末法呢，就是还有佛法的这种教法，就是淫魔呢，就是按照这个大乘佛教的观点来讲呢，还有一段时间。只不过我们经常人们这个业力深重啊，烦恼深重啊，这个时候用末法时代，因为这个佛法是已经偏向于这个就阴谋的，就像世间的这个效果一样的话，那么就它是一种说法而已。实际上是这个法呢，就是还没有末，就是有希望。这是第一个问题。
Okay, so about your first question, you talk about the period of degeneration age, but actually in Buddhism we have the period of the fruition. We also have the period of practice.We also have the period of the main focus on the theory, and there is another period. But the first two periods are already gone. We are in the second period. So we are still not, we are not worse now. But sometimes when we talk about people nowadays have lots of negative emotions and we have lots of negative karma, this period is like the, is very dark, but this is onlya kind of opinion, this is a saying, we still have hope.
然后第二个问题，你跟那个肾就是是谁厉害是吧？你厉害还是肾厉害？魔厉害，魔鬼厉害还是什么？肾厉害是吧？实际上，如果我们的性就是经常处在一个非常快乐跳入然后幸福就这样的一个状态当中的话，说明是肾厉害。
So you want to understand, you want to know the power of God and the power of demons. So if you are very happy, your mind is very relaxed and gentle, and under this case, the power of God is greater.
如果我们的心呢，就是处于一种非常严重的嫉妒啊，严重的愤怒啊，甚至呢，就是以我的行为来，就是害其他的人，或者人类，或者是其他的动物，那么这样的时候呢，对你而言的话呢，就是这个魔都比较厉害了。
And in other cases, if in your mind you have lots of jealousy, you are very easy to get angry, you want to harm.People, you want to harm animals. Maybe in this case, the power of demon is greater.
Thank you very much. So we're very happy that Kripa Sotagye could come here and all the studies that will listen. So thank you very much to everybody, Kempo and everyone else here. And we also want to ask you if you could just remain.Seated until I let Kempo Sotagye leave first. Okay, thank you very much.